to our budget review today. I'm Steve Timmis from Sempar, Accountancy and Tax, and I'm joined today by our head of tax, Pete Rossiter. Hi, Pete.
Hi, how you doing?
Yeah, not bad at all. I think a very interesting day, probably the most watched budget in our lifetime, don't you think?
Yeah, I think everyone was anticipating quite a lot of changes. I do think there was a lot of changes that had happened, but for businesses on a whole, I think they weren't bad. The big headline that probably catches everyone's attention is the corporation tax increase. But other than that, I feel that especially with the COVID, there's some positives for businesses.
I think everyone is expecting some element of payback, weren't they, in terms of some tax rise. There's a lot of rumours circling prior to the budget, but a lot of the capital tax and the inheritance tax and wealth taxes that were sort of rumoured before, changes to those haven't come to fruition, have they?
No, I don't think so. I don't think we're probably along the line of the journey of the COVID recovery as we thought we were when those rumours came out. So we might have to see what happens next year. But for now, we're safe on those transactions.
And we know where we are. And like you said, although there's that that big negative, which is the hike in corporation tax, it does spare small businesses in terms of the fact that those making smaller profits aren't affected. And there will be some element of marginal relief for those in that below that 250,000 bracket.
Yeah, definitely. And it comes in 2023. So things can still change and we can also plan for it. It's not coming in tomorrow, so we've got plenty of time to have a think about the way businesses want to go.
Yeah. And but on the positive side, there's a lot of positives for businesses in terms of innovation with the super deduction.
Yeah, they're looking to get people to innovate their businesses, try new things, and actually get rewarded for it. I think that's good, and it's the landscape that we're in at the moment. All businesses have had to innovate in the last 12 months or they got left behind. And I think they're starting to reward that, which will be good.
Mm-hmm. The coronavirus, obviously, we're still in the pandemic and we've got our roadmap now. And certainly the Chancellor's done his bit to extend that support to make sure that businesses are well supported through that roadmap, isn't he?
Yeah, it needed to be extended to beyond us coming out of lockdown. It needs to support those businesses that will still struggle for work in the first 6 to 12 months after coming out of lockdown. So those with the support grants that will be for the restarting of the business, it's given businesses that opportunity to give it a go post-COVID.
Yeah, I think a real highlight of that for those who started self-employed businesses in 2020, very much now included in the fourth and fifth self-employed grants, which can only be positive for those people because I think they will have had a fairly torrid 2020.
Yeah, those people who decided to go self-employed and then they didn't have a year to qualify, it's been a very tough 12 months for them. And so for them to be able to be put back into a scheme and actually get some help from the government was imperative.
Yeah, so just on the coronavirus support, you know, it's worth just highlighting those measures. We know that furlough now extends to September with some reduction in contribution as we get past July. Like we said, the self-employed grant, there's a fourth and a fifth grant, but he did say that the fifth grant was the final grant. So he's committed that that's going to come to an end at that point. There's an uplift in universal credit for those claiming universal credit. So, you know, I think he's been fairly considered about all parties. I think the one sector we talked about before that's kind of got left out again is that director-only limited company.
Yeah, it's been a tough one. It's been a tough one for a lot of limited company owners in the last 12 months to not have that support when their staff members have been able to have that support. I can't really say why they haven't. All I can think of is that they haven't found a mechanism to be able to differentiate between the dividends an individual would receive as a business owner as as a replacement of their remuneration and for the benefits of their profits. And they've not been able to find a way that they could stop it being manipulated anyway.
Yeah. Well, like we said before, I think with the owner-managed director-only company aside, it's largely a positive budget for the businesses. What's your highlights of the changes that have come in on the positive side for businesses?
I think one of the biggest positives for businesses and business owners is actually the things that they didn't say. And a lot of talk was getting rid of capital gains tax exemption, putting it up to match income tax levels, and also scrapping of the entrepreneurs relief. All of that's still in place. So I think that's massive for businesses to actually incentivize people to actually start their own business, to be part of a business, because if those go, the incentives of employing people and growing a business start to dwindle. And so I see that as a massive plus at the moment.
And we've got this new super deduction for capital allowances, which will definitely encourage clients and businesses to spend money on plant and machinery. But I think we need to wait a little while to find out the detail before everyone goes out and starts spending, don't we?
Yeah, it's a great headline for the government, because 130% relief sounds brilliant, and it could be for some businesses, but we don't know the detail on what qualifies at the moment. So we just have to wait to see on that one.
Yeah. And continuing the coronavirus recovery, we've got the new loans that the government's pledged, so the sort of follow-up to the bounce back loans that are going to be backed 80% by the government. We've got the doubling up of the apprenticeship support as well. So there's plenty of good things, especially for growing businesses. You know, often we work a lot with growing businesses. So anyone out there that's really pushing their business along, and maybe in a sector that's unaffected or, you know, now bouncing back, certainly there's a lot of good news in there, isn't there?
Yes, definitely. I think the growing business are really going to benefit from the budget and the extra support that can be there. So just probably in the next 12 months, hopefully we can start to get customers back to clients, and all these measures can really push their businesses forward.
Mm-hmm. And from a taxation point of view, I think we've got, again, it was good and bad. So we mentioned the corporation tax that is clearly going to impact some of our clients and some of the businesses. But like you say, we've got this lag of time before it comes into play, and plenty of time to plan for that. Personal taxes for individuals have been frozen, personal allowance frozen at 12,570. Clearly there is a negative impact to that in terms of as wages go up, they're going to fall into different tax brackets, and the revenue, and the government will make a gain from that. But still, at least we've got some certainty, and you can always deal with certainty, can't you?
Yeah, definitely. We know it's not going to change, and you can plan for that. So it hasn't gone down, nothing's been removed. So I see it as, although it's not great that it hasn't increased, it was never going to increase in this budget when they're just trying to tighten the ship somewhere.
Yeah. It's and of course, we've got the extension of the stamp duty, which will please some home buyers who may be getting quite tight to the end of March for their purchases, and hopefully we'll keep that construction and property market ticking over.
Yeah, the property market keeps a lot of the businesses ticking over and a lot of the industry, doesn't it? So I think it was quite important for it to continue and keep people continuing to buy, because buying houses also means that people are buying other things and spending money. And that's what the government really wanted from this budget, is people to spend money.
Yeah. Brilliant. Well, thanks for joining me today, Pete, on our budget review. I think, like we say, as an overview, it was largely positive. We knew where we were. We knew we were going to have some elements of clawback for COVID. There's lots of talking points to have with our clients. If any of you out there need, anything in that budget that you want to discuss, feel free to get in touch with one of the team. We look forward to talking to you about it. So, thanks for joining us today. Thanks again to Pete, and see you soon.
Yeah, thank you. Bye.